Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about string and array rotation. Okay, so your problem statement is something like this. You have an array, okay, which array is something look like this, 5, 6, or it can be a string also, and like hello world. And there can be a question, okay, rotate this string till nth position, okay. And you see this nth position, like if I talk about rotate this particular array till 2 positions. So what does it mean? That my final output array should be 6, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. This is my new array after rotation. Similarly, it can happen for the string also, the d, and if you are rotating this string, then final will be dl, then hello, this will become my new string, okay, because d will come first, then l will get rotated and it will be put on the forward position and the rest will be the same, hello, and these two characters are coming back, okay. So it's all about string and array rotations, and we are going to use these three different methods, okay, in array.prototype. We have these methods, which one is pop, okay, shift, okay, and there is one another method is unshift. They are actually very important methods when it comes to a rotating of an array or inserting new element from the forward position, backward position, and push pop, that you are already aware, push and pop, okay. So just let's talk about pop. So this is my array. So this is my array. When you do the pop, what it you will get? You will get 4. When you will do a push in the current array and you push 6, then you will get new element after doing pop 1, 2, 3, 6, because you have already popped 4 element, 4th one. Right. Similarly, there is another method, shift. Okay, what it does? Shift will actually remove the elements from the forward position. So if you do the shift here, then the remaining array will be 2, 3, 6. And when you do unshift, it will actually unshift like a particular element you are passing, then it will actually add that onto the forward position. So it will become 5, 1, 2, 6, something like this. Okay. So we are going to use these set of methods to solve our problem. And it is very easy when it comes to a JavaScript. It's very easy to just deal with this problem. Const array rotation. Okay, this is, we are getting array and the nth position till which you want array rotation. So we are just running a loop. Okay, let I is 0, I is less than n. I mean the position, nth position, because we need to run this loop only till nth position. What we will do is, here we will do array.unshift. Okay. So whatever you are doing a pop from array, we will actually unshift that. Okay. Now if you just understand this logic, what we have written, and just return the array from it. Now what we are doing is, here is, this is my array. Okay, I will keep doing pop. So when you do the pop, you will, once you do the pop one time, you will get 6, then you will get 5, then you will get 4. Okay, and we are running iteration. If you are keep doing pop, we are keep doing unshift. So these elements keep getting added. So first time you did pop 6, so my array become 6, 1, 2. Then you did pop of 5, so my array become 5, 6, 1, 2, ... right? So this is simple logic we have implemented. Now another, on the same line, there can be two different kind of rotation. So sometimes you want is, okay, I want a rotation, the first element should go to the right hand side, okay. So consider that you want to, this is your simple array you got, okay. My problem statement is like this. I wanted to rotate it from the right hand side. So if I wanted to rotate it for the two position, then what I want is 1 and 2 should append it in the back of the array. So you will see only 3, 4, 5, 6. So 1 is getting rotated. So it will get 1, then you will get 2. Okay. How we can do this? We can simply do push, okay, array dot push and array dot shift. Okay. So simply array dot push and array dot shift. Simple. Array rotations from the right hand side, from the left hand side, right? So what it is doing is it is keep adding the new elements. So if you wanted to add any element at the end of the array, obviously you will do a push. But how you will get an element? Using doing shift. So when you do array dot shift, it will remove the first one, and array dot push will keep added. Then again you do array dot shift, it will remove the second element, and you are doing a push, so it will get added in the last. Okay, cool and simple. So this is how we can do the array rotation. Okay, thanks everyone. In the next video, we will talk about searching a set of strings from a paragraph from a particular document.